Hello, everybody. I hope everybody had a great Mother's Day yesterday. Happy belated Mother's Day to all you mothers out there. And thank you all for helping your kids get through this. This is the start of week 8. The end of this week will be 2 months. We've been in quarantine and out of school doing schooling at home. So I just want to make sure you know what your kids are supposed to be doing. So your job should just be to tell them, hey, get to work, show me that you're done, turn it into your teacher. Your teacher will give you feedback. It's not my job as the parent. My job as the parent to just make sure you're doing the work, and check in with me to make sure they are getting their work done because I'm keeping track of everything I get. So this is what Classcraft looks like. If it looks like a game, it really isn't. I also use Google Classroom, so don't worry. Kids are getting the same consistent structure they've had all year. Google Classroom, they're using it with all their other teachers, and Classcraft they've used in science since day one back in September. Kids should be going to the messaging, and every time there's a green dot, they need to read what I wrote. This is me communicating and giving direct feedback to your child. Right there. I can do that. You just need to make sure they've got a space and a place to work. And in the class announcement, I put announcements in there every day, so your kid should be checking it every day, just so they know. But here's where the work gets done. This part right here called quests. Right now we're in this island. And this is what it should look like right now. Kids should be done with Think Like a Scientist by now, and all students should have been working on climate change. I mentioned last week, if they watched 2 to 3 videos a day with me teaching, they could have gotten done last week. And then the ACE dot is really cool because that's where they publish their climate change blog post. And then they've got a quiz here to make sure I can just check up on them, make sure they learn what they had to. And then ocean acidification is great because kids are going to learn, besides plastic, what else is endangering our marine life and our oceans. But this week, before we get started with the whole Minecraft science projects, we've got water quality. So your kids can click on here. They can read the steps. I've got it broken down step by step, where it says watch the videos. There are videos of me showing them everything, step by step, what they need to do. So leave the teaching to me. You just make sure they're doing it and watching the videos. And I tried to keep them as short as I could. I mean, I'm doing a lot of teaching here, so I couldn't keep them all to 3 minutes or so. But I did every chance I got. So I split it up into chunks so kids can get up, take a break, so they're not sitting in front of a computer all day. And they can spread this out so they don't overwhelm themselves. Now this one's long because I actually went down to the creek and recorded myself testing the water quality because I couldn't take them with me. So everything they need is here. I've got links to the data, plus I show them what to do with it. So this is so you know how I'm helping your kids, and really so you don't have to feel the stress of having to teach them the science, because that's what I'm here for. So I hope this helps. Have a great week, and yeah, 2 months. We got this. We're gonna make it.